you, may I ask you today, have you ever opened your mouth today to say something? Raise your hand, you did. Everybody did it. When you open your mouth, you give a speech. This is the reason we give a speech every day, every moment, or almost. Keep going in your mind. Today, I want to share with you how to choose a topic for a public speech, like in the Toastmaster, or you are invited to give a speech, guest speaker. When you speak, give a speech, you need to know what in deal for your audience. You must know that. You must know that. They must bring something home. Therefore, when you give a speech, it must be useful for them. Based on this kind of idea, I want to share with you how to find your topic and how to give the speech and how to choose the topic. Actually, we can have all kind of topic. However, basically, there's only two categories you can find the topic. One is from your own experience. One is from other outside sources. For your own experience, for example, you can talk about the interest, your habit, your travel experience, your sports, your investment, your retirement. It's really to everybody. You can talk about the career, for example, the business process, ethics, investment, or retirement. Then you can talk to your family, like your ancestor, your children, your how to raise them, the insight, their experience, your marriage, your divorce, your tradition. And then you can also have your own education. For example, your study habit, your achievement, your memorables, your teachers, and your memorable subject. Therefore, you can look at yourself, find all kinds of topic. Why? Because you, almost everybody is the same as the other audience. So you have this experience, they can resonate with you. They can bring something home with what you tell them. The second thing I'm talking about is the outside resources. For example, you can find from the website. There is a medical website, university research, and so on. You can find the topic. That will. The second of all is the books. Everybody reads books. If you never read books, you cannot be a Toastmaster, okay? I'm telling you. And there's a review of the books and a lot of kinds of possibility. You can talk. And also you can come from the magazines. Times magazine, a newspaper, or High Chinese American News. Those kind of topics, you can find it, you think interest, then you can talk about it. And the newspaper, as what I said, and you can talk about the current event, you can talk about opinion, you can talk editorial, travel, everything. Based on these two resources, sometimes you walk in the trail, all of a sudden you're inspired with something. Do you ever have this kind of experience? You want to talk about that? In that case, I want to share with you. You see, every time I go anywhere, I bring my notebook. Even in my car, I bring a notebook. Whenever I have some kind of invention, new idea, I write down. Whenever I want to have a topic, I write down. I want to share with you. you can do the same thing too. Just a pocket. Right now you might have a cell phone, you just keep the cell phone email to yourself. You have something in print. Because this kind of inspiration idea struck your head. 2 minutes left, it's gone. It's gone. Gone with the wind. It's gone. So you write down, you can go home, think about it, write down in your diary. Then you can keep those in file. In the future, when you talk, meet, then you can bring this and give a speech. Now we talk about from yourself and outside and so on, you can have all kinds of topics. When you give a speech, it's only 5 to 7 minutes. Therefore, you need to narrow down your speech. You cannot talk everything. That's nothing. You can talk anything. So you need to narrow down. When you narrow down, you need to understand one thing. Do you ever sit in the stand in the elevator, just talk to a person, say, how you dealing with your wife? What's the problem? You don't do that, right? Too personal. The same thing for the give a speech. You need to think what's the relationship between you and the audience. As a relationship, then you can choose a right topic. Don't talk something, embarrass you, embarrass other people. You figure that part out. As what I said, when you give a topic, you need to figure out what the people will bring home. What the people will bring home. In order to understand that, therefore, if you are invited to give a public speech, you need to learn several things. One is who they are, what they are. Their gender, what they do, what age group, and the what's their educational level, what's their working experience, and what kind of community they are in. All those things affect what you are trying to talk to them. Also, you need to ask how many people will attend today. 7 people, 6, 7 people. And it's totally different from 10,000 people, 5,000 people, totally different. So you need to know those kind of things. Also, you need to understand whether they already know the topic. What kind of training they got to understand it. In addition to know those things, you need to know what kind of occasion if you are invited as a speaker for the meeting. Right? Then you need to tell them, you need to ask whether there is a theme for this occasion. For example, Toastmaster annual convention or Battelle 100 years anniversary. You need to know that and you need to tailor your speech to that theme if possible. Then one thing is important. You need to know your speech is the very beginning or in the middle or in the end. You need to know the transaction where you are in this meeting. Otherwise, you say something maybe very odd. Then, one important part, you need to know right after your speech what's continuing. Because you need to put a transition between your speech to another. A lot of people just say something, the other people cannot continue. So you need to add these transactions. After all those, one thing is important. Can you do it? You need to consider your ability. Are you able to deliver that speech? I give an example. You don't want to do something you cannot do. You, for example, okay, do you have enough enthusiasm and interest toward the topic you are trying to talk about? And if you do have enthusiasm and emotion, you will attract the audience. If you don't talk about that, because that's not in you. People know. Second of all, do you have knowledge required to conduct that topic? The third one is, do you have the authority? Would the audience believe you have the authority to talk about that? Just like Bill Gates, he had the authority because right now he's the area governor, so we know he was the president before. We know he's the authority, and he is a very mature man. So we believe him. The last one is, you need to be specific. We can choose all kinds of topic, right? But you only have 5 to 7 minutes. So you need to narrow down. How to narrow down? You need to make sure the topic is time allowed. You need to have enough sub-point to support your topic, and you need to know how to cut off those things not important. A lot of people say, oh, I have a lot of things I want to say, I don't have enough time. That's a bad speaker. You didn't prepare. You only have this time in a specific. In conclusion, choose the topic is easy, really easy. From your personal experience, do some little bit of research and know your audience. Important part is put your enthusiasm in. Enthusiasm. Then people really, really think they will get something from you. Thank you very much.